Welcome to another episode in the series Dr. Peart and First Aid. I'm going to talk about a situation which occurs quite often, and the management of this situation can decide how a person progresses or whether they deteriorate. I'm going to talk about head injuries. Now, an injury to the head is always something to consider. Now, some of them might be trivial, and meaning that you get up and bump your head on a table or something like that. You're searching for something and knock your head on an open cupboard door. That sort of trauma is trivial. But if you fall from a ladder and hit your head, or you hit your head as part of a motor vehicle accident, or somebody hits you with a large blunt object, or God forbid you get a missile injury like a stone flung or a gunshot wound or so, that sort of head injury is something serious and that should be sent on to hospital as quickly as possible. If a person falls and hits their head and the person becomes unconscious, if that unconsciousness lasts for more than 3 minutes, the person should be just headed straight for hospital or a medical facility. But they will need to be observed for 24 hours. If they, after a head injury, they remain unconscious for more than 3 minutes. Now, if it's under 3 minutes, it's likely that they have what is called a concussion. A concussion really means that the brain moves up and down in the skull, but did not suffer any great damage. The damage is what we call physiological. It means that you might be disoriented after a while, you might have a headache, you might have a loss of memory for the incident itself or for the antecedent time of the incident. But that person under 3 minutes will be okay most of the time. But if any person has a head injury and there's bleeding from the ear, nose, or throat, if there's a asymmetry, meaning one eye looking bigger than the other, bloodshot to the eye right after the head injury, all of those mean that the person has suffered some level of trauma to the skull and they should be brought to medical attention very quickly. Another thing you look for to see if there's a fluid running out of the ear or out of the nose right after the head injury. That could mean that there's a fracture of the skull. Fluid, blood, or blood and fluid, water, bloody water, or just clear water coming out of the nose or the ear right after a head injury, something significant, and it should be checked out. The rapidity with which you reach now for that checking out is going to determine what happens in the future, because you can get a head injury and you get a fit or a seizure right after. That is another reason to head straight for further medical attention. You can get a head injury and the person becomes just disoriented, talking foolishness, not knowing where they are and so on. That is somebody who should still reach, whether it's 3 minutes, even if it's less than 3 minutes, because it means that head injury is severe. Now, what can be happening in the head is that you can rupture a blood vessel and that bleeding might just for a short time. Person comes back up alert, but after an hour or so, they deteriorate again. So if you're having what we call fluctuating levels of consciousness, that's another reason to head for medical attention. If there is, this is not something you can give sweet sugar and water and hope for the best for, right? If there is vomiting after a head injury, that's another significant happening. And that person should be brought to a hospital situation and be kept over a 24-hour period at least for observation to see if their level of consciousness is changing also. And of course, the usual skull X-ray, then going on to even CAT scan and MRI if they are necessary. So a head injury is especially an older person where the vessels are more brittle, and so they can rupture easier, and so they can get a bleeding in the brain. Either a hematoma, a subdural hematoma, it's a clot of blood inside the brain which can cause all sorts of problems which will need surgical intervention. Or if it's a small bleed, then that sometimes the body reabsorbs that blood, but they still need to be observed. So any head injury with loss of consciousness of over 3 minutes should be taken quite seriously. And prevention, of course, is better than cure. In the home, ladders must be kept firm. If people are going up there, objects overhead, stored overhead, should be light. And if they are heavy, they should be well anchored. Of course, we know that there's a level of domestic and other kinds of violence, and that is something that we should just try and avoid. And if you're going on roofs to fix things, so just be careful, because your falls from heights are one of the causes of head injuries. People who have problems with dizziness and all that should know that that kind of problem can cause them to become unsteady and fall. Elderly people can fall and hit their heads, and if especially if it's an elderly person, they fall and hit their head, and you notice that change in their behavior or a change in their consciousness level, then such a person should be taken to a hospital for observation and further investigation. So in a nutshell, head injuries can occur from blunt trauma, meaning something solid hitting them, a fall, motor vehicle accident, or willful trauma, missile injuries. Anything that causes a loss of consciousness for more than 3 minutes, any case like that should be sent to hospital, especially if you have ear, nose, and throat bleeding. If you have water running from the nose or from the ear, or bloodshot in the eyes. And the water from the nose or ear in a head injury is usually what we call cerebrospinal fluid, and that fluid running out can mean that there has been a skull fracture. So that, in a nutshell, is how you deal with a head injury. Under 3 minutes, you have a little time. If under 3 minutes of unconsciousness, you have a little time to reobserve. But over 3 minutes, with any of those other things, the change in behavior, vomiting, bleeding from the ear, nose, or bloodshot sign in the eyes, any of those, the patient should be carried hospital for observation. Thank you for listening, and join us again soon for another episode in First Aid with Dr. Peart.
Hello viewers, my name is Ian Bennett, I'm the manager of Computer Genie. With me is Mr. Anthony Taylor, technician here at Computer Genie. I'd like to invite everyone in and to tell you that if you have any problems with your brand name computer, just like it's the Dell that we have right here, or a generic computer, locally assembled computer, feel free to come to Computer Genie and we can rectify the matter. As a matter of fact, I'm willing to give you a guarantee that within 2 hours, we can tell you what is wrong with your computer. So feel free to call us, telephone number you see on the screen, 988-1716, or to visit us here. So, Computer Genie, 988-1716. 1716. Call today. Hello viewers, Ian Bennett here, and I have a deal for you. In my hand is the DXG 5 megapixel digital camera. 5 megapixel, well actually 5.1 megapixel digital camera. With this camera, for example, I know someone who works with one of the local media houses, and what they use is a 3 megapixel camera. So if they can be using that for a newspaper, then you must have an idea of what type of quality we're talking about here. Alright, this camera comes with a 2-inch LCD screen. There you can see it right here. And a 4x digital zoom along with all the cables. Okay, so we have the cable that you can actually hook it up to your computer here with it. And a neat little pouch here for you. That's probably somebody calling us, asking us to acquire one right now. It's for only 12,500, right? And now whether or not it's me you're coming here to speak to, whether or not you call and get me on the phone, or Miss Barton, feel free to come in and take advantage of this deal. Only 12,500. Hello viewers, Ian Bennett here. I'm here to give you good news. Computer Genie now has a shop in the Portmore Mall. Yes, we're in the Portmore Mall. So you can come and get your usual good service and low prices at most convenient shop in Portmore. We are across from the Paymaster and next door to the NCB ATM booth. Call us 988-1716 now.
Some Jamaicans, the sound of a police siren means that the forces of law and order are coming to the rescue. But to others, the sound of a siren means trouble. Too often, gunshots echo through the streets. Fear is in the air. Often we react without thinking, and violence leads to more violence. When things go wrong, how should the security forces and the citizens react? Are there rules?
There are laws governing the behavior of the police and citizens, but often we don't know our rights and responsibilities, and the police may not behave as they should.
There are rules that police officers are required to follow when questioning a suspect, when making an arrest, and citizens too have rights and responsibilities. If both security forces and the public follow the rules, well, let's see how things should go.
Police, police!
Don't run, man. We're innocent. Well, gentlemen, morning. Your name's... My name is Roger Thomas, officer. And you? And his name is Trevor Brown. Where do you live?
24 Rise Lane, sir. Listen, gentlemen. We have a report of a robbery committed. Of two young men committing a robbery. And the description fit both of you. I'll have to take you to the station for questioning in connection with the robbery. Could you kind of hold your hands, please? Open hands, please. Let me search you.
Officer.
You are not obliged to say anything unless you wish to do so. Whatever you say will be taken in writing and maybe given evidence.
You know nothing to say, officer.
No, I didn't say you were guilty, sir. Just that we have to take you into custody to ask some questions as related to that robbery. I want to ask some questions. You don't want to say anything now? Do you have a lawyer?
No, no, sir.
Well, if you don't have a lawyer, the state will provide one for you. Now, do you want me to call a lawyer for you, sir?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to call a lawyer for you. For me to ask you any question, duty counsel must be present. Okay? And you're entitled to legal representation all the time. You're also entitled to a phone call to call a relative or a friend to tell that you're at a station. Take it easy, take it easy. We're only here to question you.
Now, whether these young men are guilty or not, the police and the youths have behaved correctly. As it happened, Roger was released, and Trevor was held and charged. But suppose things had gone wrong, really wrong, as in this scenario.
We was just walking around minding our own business, me and my brethren. So the car drive down with the two officers of them, and one of them fly out of the car and start call out to me, "Yo boy, come here!" So them start walk up to it. So I man start run, and him pop out him gun and bust a shot off of me, you know. So my brethren say, "Yo, you can't do that." And the next one just come behind me and lick me in the head so with him button, and I drop on the ground. After me drop, the two of them start kick me up.
After me drive up, me tell the boy them, "Don't move." This boy run up and down. I lucky him lucky today, you know, man. Him thinks that me have strength to run off of them. And when he run off of them, them friendly wait and kill you. Me not make none of them take no chance off of me, you know. I fire, me have to fire my gun before him kill or stop, you know. Cause he say me serious. Me not run off of them. Is that them here, my shot and stop?
All blood start run out of me eye. You know me? And the two of them just pack me up and just throw me in the Jeep and carry me away. Straight down a station.
Even when things go wrong, there are steps that can be taken to obtain justice. Trevor's friend knew he needed advice from someone he knew and trusted, and so he went to the principal of his old school.
So you say you told your friend not to run. No, that was wise. We must never resist arrest. But you said the policeman fired his gun, and that is not right. That is not right.
But sir, it didn't hit Trevor.
It don't matter if it hit Trevor. The policeman fired his gun carelessly. So what am I for that?
The beat up Trevor. His head was bleeding and they flung him in the police car.
So did you see any of the numbers on the policeman's shirt?
Didn't see a number.
You asked their names?
I tried to, sir, but they told me to shut up my friggin' mouth and drove off.
Did you get the license plate number?
Mm-mm.
All right, okay. But you followed him to the police station, so what happened there?
I was worried he was hurt bad. I wanted to see him, but they never let me. They told me to frig off and threw him in a cell.
The police were supposed to have done several important things. One, they're supposed to tell Trevor of his rights. Two, they're supposed to make him see a doctor.
That's what I was worried about.
Three, they're supposed to call a duty counsel. Because they can't question him before a lawyer arrives.
None of that, go on.
Every police station have a list of lawyers that will help. The arresting officer must call one.
Trevor never know that, sir.
Well, you are going to have to make a complaint. You're going to have to complain to the police public complaints authority. Just a moment for me.
Yes.
Hello, good afternoon. Could you call back in about half an hour, please? All right? Yes. Bye. All right. Yeah, sorry about that.
Yes.
You will have to make a complaint to the police public complaints authority. It's just a pity you never get the policeman names and numbers.
I know their face, Mr. Watson. I can find them out.
So you are willing to be a witness in court?
Don't know, sir. I'm a family, sir.
I know it's difficult, you know, man. I know it's a bit difficult, but you know, it is your right as a citizen, your job as a citizen. Look, we have to stand up for our rights, you know, man. Nobody else will. Our rights and our freedoms are worth fighting for. Isn't that so?
When you put it that way, sir, I'll be a witness.
All right, tell you what. I will come with you to the police public complaints authority to make the complaint, all right?
Thank you, sir.
Good. And listen, in the meantime, just go through your mind to see if you can recapture everything that happened. And for God's sake, write them down. All right? So how the new school?
Rough.
Yes? How the chemistry?
You know, say my subject that long.
Listen now. Chewing gum and nothing makes a bum, eh?
Remember James, man.
Never resist arrest. If you are physically or verbally attacked, keep cool. The main thing is to stay alive. Keep your eyes open. If you cannot see the police officer's number, look at him and listen to him carefully so you can identify him later. Don't be provoked. Even when it seems impossible, try to be courteous. If the police are not treating you properly, call out to anyone nearby so they back you up when it's necessary. Complaints should, first of all, be made to the Police Public Complaints Authority, also known as the PPCA, or the Office of Professional Responsibility. It may help to take a respected member of your community with you. There are also a number of organizations that may be able to help. The Office of the Public Defender, the Office of the Attorney General, the Kingston and Montego Bay Legal Aid Clinics, the Independent Jamaica Council for Human Rights, and Jamaicans for Justice.
And most important of all, know your rights. There are leaflets and brochures you can get free from these organizations. If you have questions, contact Jamaicans for Justice.
Jamaicans for Justice is a non-profit, non-partisan, non-violent citizens action organization. We believe that the majority of Jamaicans are decent, law-abiding citizens. We work with others towards a Jamaica in which there is justice for all. If you want to contact Jamaicans for Justice, you can visit our office at 1 Grants Pen Road, Kingston 8, or call us at 755-4524. We are always willing to help.
I will learn my rights as a citizen.
I will respect the rights of citizens.
I will show respect for the law and encourage better relations between citizens and the security forces.
I will work with my community to support any victim of a criminal act. I will act with justice, fairness, and professionalism at all times.
If I witness wrongdoings in my community, I will speak out and not hold information.
Respect yourself, respect others.
Know your rights.
Offer Pogomo the best in wheel alignment, balancing, front end repairs, tire repairs, and other auto services. We also sell tires and batteries. Automax is located between Church's Credit Union and Empathy Funeral Home. Call us at 704-3020 and visit us today.
Dons and their gangs are turning our children against us, making them into thugs, thieves, murderers, top shotters. But we can stop them. Call Kingfish 811 from any phone. No charge, no call ID, no star 69. It's safe.
Hello, Ian Bennett here again. Do you have any wedding cassettes that you want to be put on DVD? Come to Computer Genie. Do you have any audio cassettes you'd like to be put on CD? Come to Computer Genie. Do you have any cassettes at all that you need to be put on CD or DVD? Come to Computer Genie. So you could call us the Conversion Genie. Computer Genie, 988-1716. Viewers, have good news for you. Computer Genie now offers two new services to the public. First is our on-site repair service, where all you'll have to do is call, speak to Miss Barton right here, and she'll dispatch Mr. Taylor, who will visit your home and repair your computer on-site. And second is our delivery service, where we'll deliver primarily printer cartridges. So you call, speak to Miss Barton again, and she'll dispatch someone to actually come to your home and drop off this cartridge. We'll visit you in Portmore and Spanish Town. Conditions apply. Just call us at 988-1716. That's 988-1716.
Nothing is more frightening than a sudden knock on the door, particularly after dark. It could be trouble, serious trouble. The householder is frightened, and the police officers are also tense. Who knows what awaits them inside?
Fortunately for all of us, there are laws governing the behavior of the police and citizens. There are rules which police officers must follow when carrying out a search, and there are responsibilities for the householder too. Let's see what happens when these rules are followed.
Who is this?
Police officers. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Are you Miss Brown?
Yes, sir.
Could we speak to you?
Yeah.
We have reasons to believe that you might have stolen goods.
Rear officer?
Premises.
Una have search warrant?
You have the right to ask for a search warrant, but the police may also search your premises without a warrant if they are pursuing a suspect or if they have reason to believe that an offense is being committed or about to be committed on the premises.
Okay, we'll need you to accompany us whilst we have a look around.
You must follow the officers throughout the search. At all times.
Officer, where are you looking for the cushion?
Just look exactly what I'm doing. Please cooperate with us, Mr. Brown.
We accompany us inside here also.
What's up, Miss Maisie? You need to come over here, Miss Maisie.
No, Jake, it's all right. Thank you.
Well, so far.
But if you don't tell me first, me can't help you, no? Officer, I'm in knees on them, you know, sir.
Miss Brown, I'm going to have to take these articles with me. There may be evidence in a case of robbery. So everything that I take here, I'm going to put in writing and give you a list of it.
So
okay?
We're going to ask you to accompany us to the station.
Whether or not there is any evidence of a crime or any illegal activity, the police must always act with respect and courtesy, and so must the citizen. But as we all know, it doesn't always happen that way.
If nobody follows the rules, a house search could turn into a disaster.
Can you imagine? I sleep in my deep blood banging on my door when me jump up and go out. Now the police boy them, ask them what them want. Them come to my boss and me must move out of the way and give them pass. Me still insist we find out what them want. Ask them for them police ID and come to my boss and me must give them mama if we move out of the way. You don't see it. And continue to tear up my clothes and mash up my dress and mash up my place and teeth my knees jewelry and that hurt me, you know. I go to and I watch my gear for your graduation, you know. But me and them, you know, me and those nastiness, you know, because they think it'll go hence, so come in now left it, so come me have me right as I sit in the suit.
The police officers have a different story to tell.
Yeah, she said she not let me in. Because I kind of nasty, dirty, bad word. She called me a kind of dirty name. She toast, and all them way there. Tell her forget those in house. And then she turned around to her piss pad power.
Two wrongs don't make a right. whose story to believe. Whether or not a crime has been committed, both citizens and police must act according to the rules. Mrs. Brown goes to her pastor for advice.
Look, whether the jewelry found is evidence of a crime or not, everyone is innocent until proven guilty.
I know that, Pastor.
You said you did not get the names or the numbers of the police officers?
Pastor, me hear them call one bigger, him kind of tall and him look healthy. And there was a short one there who look kind of much older, but him have moustache and him head shaved, and him talk very low, Pastor.
No, Maisie, listen. The police, they have brought certain allegations against you. I hope you're growing up rude to them, and you didn't use any bad language or anything like that.
Well, Pastor, you know me long time, sir. And then they really mess up my house and mash up my things. Them. And I said two bad words, yes.
Maisie.
But me did lose my head, Pastor, my mind.
Did you make a list of the things that that were destroyed? And
yes. My neighbor, Jake, from next door, him take this picture of the bedroom and the dining room. Seem all right down the date and time at the back of it, Pastor. I'm willing to come talk to you anytime, sir.
Jake seem like a very good neighbor.
Yes, Pastor. Him also say when if we're going to court or anything, yeah, him be willing to come give evidence.
Well, that is very important. You know, I know that sometimes people are very, very weary about coming to give evidence as witnesses. But you know what the Bible says?
Yes,
we are our brother's keeper. And if any of us witness any crime or injustice and we do not tell it or report it, we are as guilty as those who are doing the wrongs. We are upholding the wrongs.
No, Pastor. Jake is willing to speak up, Pastor.
Good. All right, well, tell you what. You and Jake, you go down to the police public complaints authority. Take your ID. Make a complaint.
All right, Pastor. We will do that, Pastor.
Good.
And Pastor, this is my wedding picture. They mash it up out of the frame, Pastor.
Yeah. They mash it up?
Yes, Pastor.
Oh, my Lord. You're looking good yesterday, Miss Maisie.
Thank you, Pastor.
Now, tell Mr. Brown, I must come to church next Sunday, yeah?
All right,
I'll pray
Pastor.
For the both of you.
Thank you very much, Pastor.
Okay.
At the Police Public Complaints Authority, the person making the complaint will give a statement. So will any witness. It's important to remember exactly what happened.
Remember, there are things you can do. You have the right to ask the police if they have a signed search warrant. But even if they haven't, do not refuse entry. You must stay with the officers throughout their search. You may request a signed list of any articles seized. Be observant. Notice anything that can help identify the officers or their vehicle. Remember all that you are told. You may need to remember it later. And even when it seems impossible, try to be courteous. Complaints should be first made to the Police Public Complaints Authority. If necessary, complaints may also be made to the Office of Professional Responsibility. And it is best if you can be accompanied by a respected member of your community.
If you aren't sure of your rights and responsibilities, you can obtain leaflets like these from a legal aid clinic or from Jamaicans for Justice.
Jamaicans for Justice is a non-profit, non-partisan, non-violent citizens' action organization. We work with others towards a Jamaica where there is justice for all. We believe that the majority of Jamaicans are decent, law-abiding citizens, and we try to work with those who come to us for help to see how we can get justice in their particular situations. If you wish to contact Jamaicans for Justice, you may visit us at our office at 1 Grants Pen Road, Kingston 8, or call us at 755-4524. We are always willing to help.
I will learn what my rights are as a citizen.
I will act with justice, fairness, and professionalism at all times.
If I witness any wrongdoing in my community, I will speak up and not hide any information.
We must overcome evil with good. We are all our brother's keepers. I will work with my community to support any victim of a criminal act.
Respect yourself, respect others, learn your rights.
I'm Tanya Richards, Portmore Youth Empowerment Officer. I'm also the manager of the Portmore Youth Information Center. We are located next door to the Edgewater Community Center at the Edgewater Roundabout across from the Land Civic Center. We're open on Monday to Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. So please come on over and make full use of the services being offered here. Thank you.
Hello, viewers. You know what this is? I have a special item for you. I prefer to call it the replacement genie. Okay, what is this system? This system is the ideal one for those of us who probably have a computer at home that is giving us too many problems, and it's probably about 2, 3, probably as much as 5 years old. Okay, however, your monitor is still working, and so is your printer. And you have been contemplating that it's about time you buy a new machine. Okay? Well, this is the machine for you. We have priced this especially for those persons, and it is available all by itself. Okay? No keyboard, no monitors, no printers, nothing else. Just this system unit. Now let me run through the specifications for this system unit. It comes with an AMD Athlon processor, 256 megabytes of RAM, an 80 gigabyte hard drive, floppy drive, a 16x DVD ROM drive for those of us who want to watch DVD movies with our computer. It is an 80x mini tower case. It comes with a fax modem for those of us who want to use dial-up to go up onto the internet. And it also comes with a network card. So if it is that you want to, you know, use ADSL or DSL onto the internet, well, this machine is already done up for that. Okay? It comes with a 1 year warranty, full warranty on parts and labor. Okay? So come to Computer Genie and ask about the replacement genie. I'm quite sure that the price that we have put here, you'll find that it's right up your stream. And there's nothing that you could be doing at home right now that this system wouldn't be able to deal with those requirements. Okay? So when you're ready, call 988-1716 or 771-1818 and ask about the Computer Genie Replacement Genie. Okay? Bye for now. Hello viewers, Ian Bennett here again for Computer Genie. And today I have two things I'd like to show you. The first one is the LiveView TV Tuner and Capture Card, and our Easter special. Now, before we go any further, let's start with the TV tuner card. This is the LiveView 2000 TV tuner card. What can it do for you? That's the question you may be asking. Well, with this device, you can watch TV on your computer, capture video images, say from a cable TV or normal TV, edit video, and listen to your radio. So Lamasha, what does this mean for you? Well, if you're at home and you decide that you need an extra TV inside your room, you really don't have to go over to any one of these appliance stores and acquire a TV. You could come to Computer Genie, acquire one of these cards, we'll actually install it inside your machine, right? Then you'll be able to watch TV on your computer, listen to the radio, you listen to IRFM, whichever one of the stations and so on. You'll also be able to capture video images, whether it's from the cable TV or broadcast TV, whether it's from TVJ or CVM. You will then be in a position to edit these videos on your computer. Okay? Now, so that is it for the video, the TV tuner card and video capture card.
What happened? Eh? What do you tell me, say? Benji? You sure? My Benji?
Lord Jesus, Clarice. When?
Oh, you mean police just come down there and just grab Benji so and kick him up and box him up and put him in a vehicle and carry him gone? But after Benji and a wrong door? So, what then carry him gone, Clarice? What do you mean you don't know? Then you never the same place the bags them or some that. Sorry if I talk to you, so Clarice, but me turn fool, Lord Jesus, me no know if you do what you mean, then just carry me pitney and beat him up. Me go left work right now and come down there, me and you go look for him, you hear?
Imagine how a parent feels, or a sister, or a brother, a wife, a grandparent, when a family member is arrested and taken. Nobody knows where. There's a feeling of helplessness. Where do you turn?
There are rules and procedures a police officer must follow when questioning a citizen or making an arrest. And there are rights and responsibilities of a citizen who is detained. This is how it should go.
Benjamin Morris.
That's me.
So you are Benjamin Morris. I'm here to take you in for questioning.
Question about what happened, sir?
I have reason to believe that you're involved in a case of arson.
Me? No, yes, sir, no me, sir.
You are innocent, Mr. Morris, until proven guilty. Put your hand here, Benji. Want to give you a search?
But we can't get a name and
yes,
number.
So you have to go with us, sir. I'm asking you for your kind cooperation. You are not obliged to say anything, Mr. Morris, unless you wish to do so. Whatever you say will be taken on the writing and may be given evidence. Put your hands behind your back. And come with us. I must inform you of your right to legal representation. Do you have a lawyer, sir?
I don't have one.
Do you want me to contact a lawyer for you? We have a list of duty counsel.
How much would I have to pay, officer?
You don't have to pay. The state will provide one for you. Would you like me to get in touch with one for you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll do that.
Mr. Benjamin, I think your duty counsel is about here now.
Officer?
Yeah, ma'am.
I am here as your legal representative. My name is Walters.
Right, now that your duty counsel is here, I'll leave you both to communicate with each other. Thanks much.
I understand that the police have detained you on suspicion of arson. You are not supposed to answer any questions unless I am present. And if you are required to attend an identification parade,